Alrighty, what's going on, guys? It's Mitch. Sorry for the echo in this area. I don't know if you can't see, but it's very windy today. As you just saw, the Luxie's on the driveway. We're going to be looking at the back drawers. We're going to be looking at the tub, what I keep and where I keep it. And mainly to clean it out, get it ready for the freezer in 14 days, which is very exciting. Let's open it up. As you can see, got some little stickers for the YouTube too, which is cool. Freezer sticker, the ads, and then obviously the logo. Also is my tattoo. I haven't seen the back of this car in so long just because these are always covering it, but I want to point out something funny. Here there's this massive dent and a scratch here. And this has a bit of a bow in it here.
Last year
at Fraser, it was our last day, and I went out to, and we were meant to stay at the Cape for the last day, and we didn't really want to because it was such a long drive all the way back. Down the whole beach and then all the way home. So we decided to stay at the first campsite that we stayed at. If you've seen the videos, you know what I mean. But to get reception, to book the site, to make sure it was all good, I had to drive down maybe, I don't know, 10 minutes down the beach to closer to like a little town where there's reception. It's all good, got it all booked. Went back to the campsite to tell the boys I was going to back into where we were parking our cars and put it in reverse, threw it in backwards. And I didn't even look in my rearview mirror, but there was just a tree, just a huge tree right there. And the boys were just watching me, and it was so embarrassing, but it was so funny. I was really angry with myself though. It was funny, but I was angry. But luckily, this dent didn't affect the tailgate in any way, and we were able to... Hang on, I'll show you. Let's say it was this side. It was squished, so we couldn't get it out, right? We managed to yank the jerry can out, but we couldn't get it back in because it was had the kink in it. So what we did was Luke had the great idea to put a bottle jack here and extend it out, which would then force that in. And Luke's little genius brain worked perfectly. That's just that was just so funny when it happened. Like, it's hilarious looking back on it now, but yeah.
Tripping, am I sipping, am I high right now? The delusion and confusion got me hella tripping now. I need likes to validate me, I need pills to chill me out, I need sex to feel.
Alright, so here you can see there's a lot of bark because I collected some firewood one day, never cleaned it. But I have two drawers, King Chrome, just from Bunnings. This one I normally keep food and cooking stuff. Obviously, we need to go through that. And this one will be like snack foods. There we go. But right now I've got a spare CV and a snatch, like the weight blanket, and then a few little snatch straps under there too. But on this side, under here, I have a second battery. It's just being trickled in by the main battery when I plug it in at the moment. One day I'll get some sort of solar for it, or maybe not. I've only got one use for it, and that's a fridge when I'm going camping, so. And with big trips like Fraser, I only use the fridge for that, so. It's not much use if I have all of this like power set up, but if I need it, I'll get it one day. And then at the back, as you can see, I made all of these myself. They're terrible. I got two little chests there. Normally keep recovery stuff in there / beach stuff, and then more like tools in that one. This is just where I put random stuff that I don't know. Like right now there's like a can of Inox down in there and a sand peg and a rope. I don't know why that's all there, but it is. I'm quite literally just gonna brush my problems away. There is still sand from last year in here. Now, realistically, I'd like empty the drawers, take them out, and literally clean the whole tub. After Fraser with all the salt sand, then I would give it a really good vacuum underneath, otherwise it's just gonna rust through the tub. But with this just tree bark, I'm not really too worried about it. That looks better. It's a bit more clean. Still not clean, but for our purposes, it's all good. Now, I think I'm just gonna, I'm gonna sort through the drawers, clean them out, and explain to you what I put where. So first of all, with these drawers, obviously we've got tie downs on both. This one is actually a fridge sliding drawer. This opens right up, so we can have our fridge here. We can actually open it rather than it getting caught on the canopy. So that's why I have the fridge here, mainly because this is the fridge slide. This one doesn't slide. This is where I keep my cooking supplies, so I'm just gonna empty out the drawer and I'll show you what's in it. Now if we have it on the side, see here, let's have some basic stuff. Got an air compressor, some more flags, got a little stool to sit on, some duct tape, some vice clamps. And on this side, we got a bunch of straps that are not sorted, so I'm gonna go ahead and put those in a bag now. So I've just sorted through both chest drawers. This one I've got, under here I've got some spanners, shifters, some sockets and stuff like that. So yeah, that's just nice and tidy. From on this side I got all my ropes in there, tie downs and stuff like that. And I got room for some beach towels and whatnot. So that's gonna pretty much do it for this short little video. Sorry it was so short, but a bit of a preparation video for the trip of the year, hopefully. Head inside now. Give everything a good wash, and I'll probably tune back in with you guys on another video for when we're getting closer. Stay tuned, guys. It's happening very soon, so that's exciting. But yeah, thanks for watching, guys. If you liked, leave a like and a subscribe. But yeah, see you guys soon. Thanks for watching, and I don't know what to say.